गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. क्लास टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद SQL एंड दिस वी हैव डन लिटल. सो इन दिस बुक देर इज़ गिवन रिवीजन टूर आल्सो, बट स्टिल वी हैव टू डू इट वेरी सीरियसली. वी हैव डन इट लिटल बिट थ्योरी, वी हैव डन लिटल बिट प्रोग्रामिंग, वी हैव डन ऑफ SQL, बट वी हैव टू डू मच मोर इन दिस. So class, first of all, this chapter is related to the database management system. Database management system includes the structural organized data in which different fields and different records has been maintained, which can be stored permanently. As you all know, everywhere there is a storage of the records, and there are two type of system to store the record. One is the file based system and one is the database management system. File based system has a many limitations, that it cannot be shared, it cannot be kept permanently, there is a there can be a loss of data also, but here and duplication of the data also, data inconsistency. So all these are there, but here in database management system you can share the data, you can reduce the redundancy, duplicacy of the record that is, and data is centralized, so everyone is using the same data. No two records are made for the same person, single record file is made. So because due to all these facilities, or you can say all these properties of database management system, it is much in use nowadays. So class, in this you can see the various advantages down I have written. In this it is written, database system reduces the data redundancy, that is data duplicacy. Database system controls data inconsistency. Suppose somebody have a record and now he was living in a particular address, now address is changed. Now in file based system there will be a two records, but here it will not be a two record, it will be a single record, so it can be consistent data. And the sharing of data is quite possible with that, because it is a file based system, it is a computer based system, so it can easily be shared and people are using it different places, same data can be used. So all this is there. Now class, talking about your next topic, that is relational data model. You all know that is RDBMS, in which different records can be combined together using a different ways. Last year you have learned about the different joins about it, so this is that. Now class, first of all is a relation. A table storing logically all the data together is a relation. Domain is the pool of the value from which the actual value appearing in a given column are drawn. So that is, column is a, you can say, a domain. Tuple is a record that you are writing. Column of a attribute is the column. Degree is the number of attribute that you are creating, that is number of column that you are creating. And cardinality refers to the number of tuple, that is number of relation. So again, relation is a table. Domain, you can say that the pool from where the different column you are extracting, that is a domain. And in a existing table, what are the rows you are creating is a tuple. In existing table, what are the columns you are taking is a attribute, and the degree is the number of attribute in the relation, number of record, number of columns, and cardinality is the number of records that you are creating, that is the tuples. Now class, views. View is a virtual table that does not really exist. Suppose in a particular table I want to see the name of the employee, only employee table is there, so that is a view khali. Okay, you can say only a view it is, not a actual table. So when we use a select statement, as you if you remember, in select statement particular record comes, so that is just a view. In particular particular column comes, so that is just a view. That is not an actual table, that is just a viewer viewing it. Now primary key, you all know that is uniquely defined. Candidate key, you can say key, another key which can be used as a primary key. Alternate key, any candidate key which is not used as a primary key is a alternate key. Next is a foreign key, that is whose values are derived from the primary key of some other table, that is a foreign key. So this is the basic. Now class MySQL and SQL, this year we will change our software, we will go with MySQL. And last year we have done SQL studio management, so MySQL also I will teach you. So MySQL is a software which is used for maintaining the database, and as well as the RDBMS can also be done in MySQL. So this is one thing. Next is the classification of SQL statement. Data definition language, very important, DDL. Command that allow you to perform the task related to the data definition, like creating, altering, dropping and deleting here. So all this maintaining commands. Next is the DML, that is data manipulation language. That is command that allow you to perform the data manipulation, like retrieval, insertion, deletion, modification, all this. Above, dropping means dropping a particular field. Here the deletion means deleting a record. So these are two different things. Next is the transaction control language command, making a change to a database or making it permanent, undoing the changes in a database, creating save points. Creating save points means in this we can make our transactions, make our changes permanent also, and that can be saved also in a different file. That is creating save point. As I have told you, views, so we can create a view and we can save that view also. That is creating save points. Setting property of our current transactions, so all this can be done. Now class, the main thing while creating our database is the data types. So data type, last year if you remember, I have told you about varchar, text I have told you, long int. So similarly, these are some more data types. Int type, double is there, float is there, as we do in Python, double, float, values, date and time, you can see that, date and time, time, and so main I'm choosing, that is char, varchar, text is very important, and this int is important, float is important, date and time is important for you, and boolean also sometime we use. So these are some of the important data types that we are going to use. Now class, your next is difference between char and varchar. So class, this you have to see, this you have to study from here, read it, and if there is any problem you let me know. Now your next topic that I have chosen is for how to create a database. First of all, we create a database when we open our SQL, then they ask us to create a database. So when we create a database, we have to use the database first, then we can proceed. If you remember, we have used this command, use student, after that it start working on, we can start working on this table database. Now on creating, what we have to write, this is the syntax of it. Create, then table names are like student, then we have to give this bracket, and under this bracket we have to give column name and its type, like name text, like varchar, name varchar, we can give another like salary, salary int type. Like this we can give. Now there is a to create an employee table whose schema, 1 minute, whose schema, whose schema is as such that we want to have a e code, we want to have e name, sex, grade and gross. So class, how we will create this? So for creating it, in this way we are going to create e code. Can be an integer, it can be a char also, var char also, and this e name, sex, they have given one character maybe for male and for female f. Now grade is given and the gross is given as a gross means salary, what salary that employee is getting for that. So they have used the decimal data type. We can use float also, double also, int also, that's not a problem. It is all related, it is all what we need. Now next topic is very important, how to insert value into the table. So you first see the example, insert into employee values. After that you have to give this as according to the column that you have created. You have to give in sequence always in SQL. Similarly this is created. Now after that one more we can insert as they have created inserting the value, and other data is not given, so it will take a by default value. We can give by default also, that I will tell you later. Now similarly class, we can give a null also. Suppose we want to give certain value as null, we don't have any value right now, later on maybe somebody else or some other employee or some other data manager is going to add this value. So for that we can keep null also, that is a blank part. Now class, after doing this, last thing that we do is to select what to select, from which table to select, and what is the condition to satisfy. This is the syntax of it. Now class, like they have written last line, you can see that select star from pet. Pet is a table from which everything you want to display, you will simply write star, you all know. Next is select star from pet where sex is equals to M, means all the male sex record we want to see. So sex maybe a field is there, and in that field all M1 records will be shown. Next is the date. In date you have to see one thing, that is the format of SQL is YYYYMMDD. This format you have to see. In this format only you will work. Now after that it is given that select star from pet where birth is greater than this. So all the employees, all the members whose date of birth is greater than this date will be represented, will be shown in a view. So this is one thing. Similarly different examples are there class, this is the examples. Now next is particular column you want to display, you can give like names, birth, from pet. Similarly you want to show only the owners of the pet, so owner is also a field. Instead of star they have used this. If we'll use star everything will come, but if you write a particular column, then that particular column will only come. Next is a all keyword. All keyword is like I want to see every, means they have written like star, select all city. If we will use star also, it will give the same result. But one keyword is there, that is distinct. Distinct if you will write, then suppose there are 4 members from Ramnagar, 3 members from Kashipur, 7 members from Haldwani, then it will show you only Ramnagar, Haldwani and Kashipur. It will not show all the records. It will show only those cities which are distinct. But in this, everything will be shown. So it is simply like a star only. That's the thing. Now, viewing structure of the table. If you want to know the structure of the table, you can describe or descend command. This is for describe only, full form. And table means you want to just see the structure. Means structure means column name. Structure means how many means which data type you have given. If you want to see that, you will use this. Now class, next is performing calculation. We can perform some calculation also. Simply you have to write select, after that this type of calculation. After you enter, it will show you the result of this. Similarly, we can have a current date also, current time also. So these are some of the commands. Next is class, using column aliases. In this, as we are selecting, I want to see a particular column like date, I want to see as type, then what I will give. And in type, I want to see only the event type. There are many types, suppose event type, and suppose class, suppose there are different type is given, but I want to see only the event type ones. Okay, how many records are there from event type? So that also I can give. So class, this is one thing. So class, next is your condition based on a range. Now here you can see that there may be a table, something like items. In item OQOH is something, a column, and in that column different values are given, but I want to see the values from 30 to 50. Then I will write between 30 to 50. So, and all other description, whatever I want to see, all this description, this first column, second column, third column. And in third column, out all the records, it should show only the record which are from 30 to 50. So in between 30 to 50, and it will include 30 also and 50 also. That is the one thing. Now I want to see the record which includes cities, Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Bangalore. So in is used, not in. I don't want to see of record of Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai. I will write not in. So this is another thing. These things you have not done that much practically in class, maybe I have told you, but no problem. This year again you have to read the same. Many things are same only. So class, I am ending up my class with this topic only. There are some more topics that I have selected, but you go with these topics only. That's all class. Make a proper note of it, which are important. And if you are having the last year notes also, you can see that. And whichever the new topic you see here, you note down that. That's all class.